times. How was today's round?
Yeah, today round, okay. We played. I think it's an interesting opening. We saw it in the first Grand Prix leg in a game, Topalov Dominguez. We played with Vasily Lando. And then, okay, it was more or less equal fight. And then I think Lendier more or less blundered in time trouble or played better in time trouble, something like that. And here, I don't know. It's many ideas. I decided to, you know, to hide my knight here. Because, okay, the knight here always is red 95 and open, or 94. And here I took control of e4 square. And I think if I'll be given some time, I may get some advantage. But hard to say, but black position is very solid, and of course it's very clever. Maybe I would be fine if white already castled, because I would have this idea h3, so when black can never play h4, because the pawn would be weak. Mm-hmm. But Vasily played very strong, very strong, I would say, king
e7. And I have a question. And what would happen if white plays g3, h3, and tries to win the pawn? It is too risky to win the pawn.
G3, h3, always g5. For example, g3, some move, you play h3, g5. Ah, okay. Excellent contraplay.
Mm-hmm. Even, you know, somewhere, you know, I thought...
Before even, knight a4, somewhere...
Yeah, but even, let's say here, I don't know if a4 you have to play or not, it's possible.
Yes. Yeah?
But let's say even here, h3, I thought, but even I thought here, maybe you can play bishop h6, g4, take, and... Take here, yeah, or something. Or g5 even here. Because yes. Here it's very, okay, always rook g8 and g5. Yes. This is a key idea, black's key idea.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I told it's very clever to put king on e7 instead of castling. Because if you castle, all these ideas would be very dangerous.
Yes, after h3, white has not important square for bishop in some variation.
Yeah.
Because with pawn on h2, I almost never can play g5.
Exactly. That's why I thought here, and after h3, you know, you have g5 in many lines. Bishop h6, and you want to play g5 already, let's say.
Yes. Okay, understood, yeah.
And what other, b3, it's not an option.
Yeah.
You can even take knight g4 or something, yeah. Or g5 somewhere maybe immediately. Yeah. I didn't see what to do.
Yes, but
maybe queen in knight d3 I have to.
Yes, but,
but of course knight g4 is correct reply, and here of course you take.
Yes.
And if I would play, let's say queen e2, I think you would
take
an f5, and also the position is totally blocked. I have no chance.
Yes.
Can't black take with the
h1
and g4?
Knight e5.
No, but knight e5. This is important because it's important for me to leave this bishop. Then with you would have g4 pawn is hanging, so you'd have to take only 5 sooner or later. Mm. Then all these black squares are pretty big. Bishop
g6 is possible, but not so good.
Then rook h6, rook h8, attack on h2.
But bishop g3 always, and here I would already start b3.
Even a3, and then bishop g3, and then b3.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, exactly.
Even this.
Yeah, exactly. So, because here it's not a threat, never.
Yes.
It's a maximum check. Like queen e2, and then the b3, or a lot of ideas. For
yes, I cannot activate queen because pawn is c6.
Actually, we were looking at this game today, and we're not able to understand anything.
Actually, it's a strange game. Well, actually, one of the positions where computer understands nothing.
Yes, but we were not looking at the computer.
No, I know, but generally it's because a lot of people have prejudged that computer knows everything, you should just press button, you know, reply. But for example, this position, it's just, you would get the stupidest assessment.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember once I played
F5.
And F5 here.
Yes.
Once I played the game in this opening against Wang Yu, I won a nice game, and we just maneuver, and then certain moment computer says +5. For no reason, okay, maybe my position is winning, but okay, he just holds and I have to show beautiful tactic, it's one of my best games probably, but still. But here F5 and I'm not in time, and here already nothing to play.
Everything is blocked. So
it's blocked, it's a dead draw.
Mm-hmm.
So Vasily, I believe you played the first game against Boris back in 1985, the year when I was Boris. Yes. Many years ago. You played the first time against Boris, long time ago.
Yes.
So I think over 100 games or so.
Maybe with rapid and blitz it's and blind. Yeah. Yes.
So how can you still find ideas? Have you played so often? Is it still...
No, it's not a problem because, okay, you see, today we had interesting, and each game, it's, I don't think we had any, let's say, boring games, very few.
No, very aggressive, actually.
But, okay, because if two players want to play chess, and they would always find position in the way, that's what I think. I don't know what Vasily thinks, and it's always, of course, it's, very interesting to play such a great and creative player as Vasily.
So Vasily, with this king e7 move, I believe you are fully back after the rest day.
Yes, okay, I consider that. I don't want castle and I need to keep some fortress in that position.
Are there any questions from the audience? Otherwise, we will move to the next press conference. I see already one.